What can you say when you recognize what you did was wrong? That's what Hani Al-Shula from Saudi Arabia would like to know, and that's what we're talking about on this Learner's Question. Ah. Okay guys, now before we get started, this is a perfect time for me to tell you all about the Learner's Questions playlist. Yes, every single Learner's Questions that we've ever made is in one easy to use place, so make sure you click it. The link will be below. And of course, if you have a question for Learner's Questions, you can email us on learning.english@bbc.co.uk. So one of the easiest ways to talk about past mistakes is to use should plus have plus a past participle. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking should is a modal verb, so it doesn't change to show person or time. So how do you make a modal verb with a past meaning? Aha! Well, you do modal verb plus have plus past participle. And this puts the modal verb's meaning in the past, although it doesn't work for all of them. However, could have, would have, should have, and must have are very good examples. So, should plus have plus a past participle. For example, I shouldn't have left my job. This means I made a mistake. Somebody could say to you in the affirmative, you should have stayed where you were. This means you made a mistake, but be careful not to be rude. And of course, the question form, should I have stayed in my job? That means I'm wondering about the past. Did I mention that each one of you lucky people has the opportunity to subscribe and click the bell icon to stay up to date with all of our latest content? Imagine that I read your learner's questions out. You're going to want to tell everybody. And of course, if you have a question for learner's questions, the email address is right up there, learning.english@bbc.co.uk. Don't hesitate to contact us. Another way to talk about past mistakes is to use the third conditional. Now, it's a very long and complicated formula, and you can find much more information about it on our website. But basically, the third conditional talks about past actions and wonders what would have been different. The basic formula is if plus subject plus had or hadn't plus past participle verb, comma, subject plus would plus have plus past participle verb. Phew! For example, I shouldn't have left my job. If I hadn't left my job, I would have been paid this month. Finally, we can use structures with wish or if only to talk about past mistakes. Now, we have lots more information on these subjects on our website, so do please check it out. But basically, the structure is wish or if only plus subject plus had or hadn't plus past participle. As you can see, it's related to the third conditional. For example, I wish I hadn't quit my job. Or, for more emphasis, emotion, and impact, you might say, if only I hadn't quit my job. Did you hear the sadness in my voice? If only, if only. Thank you, Hani from Saudi Arabia, for your question. I hope we answered it. If you have a question for Learner's Questions, don't hesitate to contact us on learning.english@bbc.co.uk. And I will see you next time on Learner's Questions. Bye.
Hi everybody, it's Neil from BBC Learning English here. Did you enjoy that video? Of course you enjoyed that video. You love our videos, which is why you need to subscribe. And then you can see as many of our videos as you like and improve your English. Tell your friends too. Enjoy!